Here's the new LEGO Icons Artemis Space Launch System, one of the most impressive space-based LEGO models ever that may just be the new building challenge space exploration fans might be looking for. Or is it? As a big space fan, I've always been really excited about space-themed LEGO sets, and I'm especially thinking of the 18+ NASA-related products, as they're usually some of the most ingenious builds out there as far as the building experience goes. So when I got this from LEGO to review and not knowing anything about the model prior to unboxing it, I had the highest hopes for it all. Box art is the usual adult-styled black background boring kind, and the thick building instruction booklet matches the piece count size of the model, with the usual facts and information about it all in the very first few pages. As for the model itself, while the highlight is probably the Space Launch System and Orion spacecraft, which I'll go over in detail in just a bit, the bulk of the set and what people will be spending the most time building will actually be the impressive looking launch pad structure that completely dwarfs some other LEGO sets in terms of height. There's an access point recreated with a Technic rack element to represent stairs, and the same kind of detail can be seen behind the side structures of the platform, leading all the way to the ground floor of it all, so to speak, fenced all around with a ton of LEGO tap elements. These holes here on the ground don't make much sense without the SLS system on top, and besides that, all there's left to look at is the main tower structure. I actually never noticed it is slightly angled when seen from this side, which was done brilliantly with Technic linkage pieces, and the way the fuel hoses built onto the side of the tower also matched the angle and was really nice to put together. There's a splash of color on the opposite side of the tower with the red pipe, and on the front facing side of the structure there's all of the brackets and umbilicals to brace and fuel the rocket, as well as the crew access arm from where the astronauts go inside the crew model. I also want to point out that the way the tower was built was quite interesting, because in the middle of it all there's a sideways brick built pole onto which the different levels of the tower were slid into place, which I found really cool. The main attraction of the set though is the SLS system, an Orion spacecraft combo that fits the launch pad in here and is secured in place with these brackets. The whole thing wobbles quite a bit even with that bracing, so if you need to move the model around I would be careful if I were you. When unlocking the bracing for liftoff, it falls like it does in real life. The crew access arm can also get out of the way, and all of the arms for support and fuel move in sync and away from the rocket by pushing anywhere really, though I like to do it by moving this ball joint, and despite it all being a somewhat simple function, it does add a bit of coolness to the whole thing. Now, despite the simple look of the build, it actually packs a lot of hidden details, but before that, what's not hidden are all of the stickers, which were a bit of a pain to place correctly if I'm being honest, as most of them are placed in the middle of pieces with no visual reference or guidance that reassures the placement is indeed correct. Now don't be fooled, as some of the details on the solid rocket boosters are also prints, in fact two different kinds than in these round shaped elements, which mixed in with regular plain ones also added an extra layer of difficulty to properly put this together, as I made a bunch of mistakes by picking up the wrong element. The solid rocket boosters connect to the core stage via clips, which in turn has a much lower density of sticker use. Managed to use this dark nougat shade of LEGO bricks to a great effect, matching the real life reference quite well, and the beehive piece recolored in a dark metallic color was a very nice part usage. For space enthusiasts, however, the fact that you can play out an actual mission with all of the details hidden away on the Orion spacecraft is one of the most interesting aspects of this model. We're back to a ton of stickers here, though this cone element is printed. During takeoff, the solid rocket boosters will separate from the core stage after all the propellant is spent. Same goes with the core stage that will then release the Orion spacecraft into space. If anything goes wrong before that happens, the launch abort system here will propel the Orion spacecraft and crew away from the rocket. Opening the spacecraft like this will reveal the tightly squeezed crew module, which is an assembly where you can deploy the solar panels panels like so, topped off by yet another printed element. There is a small stand if you wish to display the crew module on the side, as well as a little info plaque featuring the last sticker of the set with some interesting facts about the entire space launch system. If you do choose to display the crew module on the side, the launch abort system would sink into the model. The reason why the set includes this bar assembly for it to be placed correctly on display. In the end, you get a very impressive looking LEGO model, faithful to the real life reference that displays really nicely if you have the space at home for it. The price of $260 is actually decent for a set with 3,600 pieces. Sure, there's lots of small elements, but when it comes to LEGO, I think you'll get your money's worth. Now, as impressive of a model this is, and as good of a deal it may sound, I gotta talk about the building experience, because for me, this set in particular wasn't enjoyable to do at all. The functions on the umbilicals were great, the angle section of the tower and fuel lines as well, but besides that, the process was very dull and extremely repetitive. Starting off with these two sides of the launch path, placing down 88 tap elements for this fence thingy, and then building these layers of the tower. All very similar, apart for some minor differences, 10 times in a row, 30 of these bar assemblies or 40 of these pillars, just to name the ones that bore me the most. All of these was around one-third of the time spent doing the set. The solid rocket boosters were, as I mentioned, a bit rough to do, and the core module was a simple studs not on top cylindrical shape we've seen done before countless times in other LEGO sets. Some people will find repetitive LEGO builds soothing, others will be able to look past that if they really enjoy the end result. But my opinion on this one, as someone who doesn't display sets for long, and having had high expectations set by previous space themed products I really enjoyed as far as the building experience went, ended up being left a bit underwhelmed. The Artemis Space Launch System is an amazing LEGO product, don't get me wrong, it's just not my cup of tea. Links for purchase in the description if you wish to support the channel, and I'll see you all in the next one.